A house is more than a building. When it personifies the family within, it is a home, or at least it should be. That an office building contains business, a house, a family, a barracks, soldiers, and a hotel. Guest is merely to cite particular instances of the architectural credo that form follows function. Buildings look like what they do. A modern sports stadium does not look like a medieval Gothic cathedral because the two architectural forms have two different functions: to entertain and to worship God. Today's feast commemorates a building, not a person. It's a memorial to the baptism or dedication of one of the oldest churches in Rome dedicated to the Virgin Mary, the Basilica of St. Mary Major. The Basilica of St. Mary Major was first built in the 35th, in the decades after the legalization of Christianity in 330, when the church could finally build big. After the Council of Ephesus' dogmatic definitions on Mary as the God-bearer in 431, the Basilica was restored and rededicated. Of the four major basilicas in Rome, St. Mary Major most retains the atmosphere, the feel of antiquity. The sites of the basilicas of St. Peter and St. John Lateran are ancient, but the present Barocco structures date from the 16th through the 18th centuries, and the ancient Paleo-Christian Basilica of St. Paul outside the walls burned almost entirely to the ground in 1823. The present structure is an impressive replica, but relatively modern. The 4th century core of St. Mary Major is, however, intact. It has been embellished, added to, and redecorated over the centuries. Nevertheless, it is to Christian Rome what is Pantheon is to pagan Rome, a complete, entire, and unscathed survivor from a built environment which has otherwise disappeared. For Catholics, every church is a Domus Dei, a house of God. Whether it is full of 1,000 souls or silent and empty, it is a house of God. A church does not keep one warm when it is cold or dry when it is wet. A church does not become such only on Sunday. A church is more than a shelter, just like a home is more than a house. A good church is theology in stone. It reflects the truths it teaches in its very shape, in its steps, in its arcs, windows, doors, lighting, marble, statues, mosaics, floors, and altars. Every Catholic church should be able to pass the deaf test. That is, when a hearing impaired person enters a church, he or she should be able to easily understand what that church is teaching without hearing a single word from the pulpit or one verse sung from the choir. A religion's hierarchy of truth should be expressed in a confident and certain manner by the structure where that religion's faithful gather to worship God. One should understand with the eyes. It is not for the Catholic to shiver in the barn of the Reformation, as one theologian wrote, and to guess what the building is trying to say. If God himself were to pull open the immense doors of St. Mary Major, one imagines he would walk down the central nave, look to his right and to his left, smile and slowly nod his head in pleasure and agreement. There, in an ornate chapel to the right, is Pope Saint Pius V. How well he guided the rudder of my ship on earth. There, under the altar, are the bones of Saint Jerome. O Cantankerous Jerome, you gave my church the definitive text of my word. There below the high altar is a relic of the manger of Christ. And there it all started, resting in that wood, my son brought the Old Testament to an end. And on and on and on. Saints, popes, the Virgin, the tabernacle, the confessionals, the stations of the cross. God the Father would not be a stranger in St. Mary Major. He would feel at home. surrounded by the things, signs, pictures, and emblems of the family life of the Universal Church. Rome is a small planet of art and beauty. The density of artistic treasures in St. Mary Major and so many other Roman churches exercises a gravitational pull, drawing all those enamored with God and His beauty toward the sacred core of the eternal city. Let us pray. Holy Trinity, our worship of you is a matter of justice more than charity. We owe you reverence in the same way a child owes honor to his parents. Our love is inflamed by the sacred beauty of churches where you, Mary, and the saints are honored with such effusions of human genius.